Hello, GCC students. This is Kim 130, Chapter 2, Video Number 2. So, we're talking about volume. In lab and in lecture, especially if this is the online course, you're going to need to read some volumes like this. So, when we look at the graduated cylinder, we see it starts at 0 at the bottom and goes up 5, 10, 15, 20 to 25, and the top tells us the unit is milliliters. So we zoom in and we can see we're above 20, and the next mark is 21, and then 22, 23, 24, and 25. So we know for sure it's 21 something. So we always write down when we take a measurement reading what we know for sure, 21. Then we get one digit to estimate. So 0.5. Maybe a little higher than that. If we look at the blow up, it looks like it's just a little over halfway. So maybe 21.6 milliliters. So that's what I would call that, 21.6 milliliters. Yeah, so that's a good guess. 21.5, 21.7 would also be okay. But for example, 20.7 would be wrong, because 20 is the line all the way across underneath the 20. 21 is the little dashed line, and then 22 is above the mark. Now, notice we make a reading where the arrow is pointing here in the middle. It curves a little bit, doesn't it? That's called the meniscus. We take the reading at the bottom of the meniscus. So where it curves, we look at the lowest point there. Don't read it up against the side. Read the lowest point. So 21.6 milliliters is a good volume for this example. Let's look at this one now. Can we read this volume? Now, this is from a 10 milliliter graduated cylinder. We're only seeing the 6, 7, 8 part. It goes from 0 at the bottom up to 10 at the top. Now, if you notice, 6 is a little bit longer, and then we have a little bit longer line, 6.5, and then 7. We're above 6.5. So these are reading in 6.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 7, 8, 9, up to 7. So we're above 6.5. And the meniscus looks like it's pretty close to the next line. So that would be 6.6. We know that for sure. It's 6.6. Then our guess is that it's kind of right on the line, so is 0. So I would call this 6.60. You could also say 6.59 or 6.61. But again, this looks to be 6.60. So for a 10 milliliter graduated cylinder, we get 2 decimal places out of the reading because we have the 0.12345 lines. So we know that for sure. So it's the 100th place that is our estimate. Compare that to the 25 mil graduated cylinder. It doesn't have 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. It just is marked in 21, 22. We don't have the points marked. That's why it only gets 1 decimal place. Okay, so a 25 milliliter graduated cylinder gets 1 decimal place. A 10 milliliter graduated cylinder gets 2 decimal places. All right, cool. Let's move on to talk about a new topic called significant digits or significant figures, same thing. I often call them sig figs for short. Significant figures or sig figs are all the digits, the numbers, in a measurement that we know, plus one more that is the estimated one that we guess at. It's an estimation. So those are the sig figs. So they tell us how accurate our measurement is. A bathroom scale versus a surgical scale. Very different measuring devices. One is pretty cheap at Walmart. One is in a hospital and costs a lot of money. Which one of those scales do you think is more accurate? Yeah, the surgical scale, right, in the hospital. So which is going to have more significant figures? Yes, the one in the hospital will. It's probably much more accurate at weighing something. Let's look at these two rulers and measure the length of the dark object. In the top ruler, we see for sure it's after 29, but we don't have any little marks in there. So we can say 29 for sure, and then we get to estimate the 0.2, I would say 0.2, 29.2 centimeters. Maybe you said 29.3 or 29.1, those would be okay, but I think 29.2 is pretty close. Yeah, 29.2 or 29.3 centimeters. Now let's look at the bottom ruler. It has little marks, it has increments. Let's look at what we know for sure now. We know for sure 29.2. We know that for sure. In fact, in between the 0.2 and the 0.3, it's closer to the 0.2. So maybe 29.23 centimeters. Maybe 29.24 centimeters. Yeah, even 29.22 centimeters would have been okay. But we know 29.2 for sure because it's in between the 0.2 and the 0.3 increments. So this gets an extra decimal place compared to the one above. So it's more accurate. That ruler at the bottom is more accurate, and we get more sig figs with it. Now in the top ruler, we got 3 sig figs, 292. 3 sig figs. With the bottom ruler, we get 4 sig figs, 2923, 4 sig figs. So, when I give you a measurement, how do you know how many sig figs are in it? So, we have 4 rules. Number 1, if it's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9, it counts. It is significant. It's a measurement number. Example, 4,895.2. All of those are numbers, so it has 5 sig figs. So what's left to talk about? Well, the zeros. Zeros are a pain. I'm sorry, GCC, but zeros can be a pain. Let's talk about the zeros in the next rules. Number 2, leading zeros, the ones in front, like 0.00. Those zeros never count. Okay, zeros in front never count. So 0.0005454, only the 5454 counts, so it has 4 sig figs. Zeros in front never count. All right, rule 3, captive zeros. Those are the zeros in between. If you're in between significant figures, then you also count. For example, 3,050 feet. That has 3 sig figs. The 3 and the 5 count, and then the 0 in between them counts. If you're in between sig figs, you count. The 0 at the end doesn't count. So 305 counts. The 0 at the end is what we call a placeholder 0. It's holding the place so that the number is 3,000, not 300. So it's important. It's just not significant. Let's go back up to number 2, 0.0005454. The zeros in front are also placeholder zeros, making the number small. They're important. You can't get rid of them. They're just not significant. Okay, so they're placeholder zeros. Back to number 3, second example, 0.002001. Again, the zeros in front do not count. They are placeholder zeros, keeping the number small. The 2 and the 1 count, because they're numbers. They count. And then the zeros are in between them, so they count. So the 2001 counts, so it has 4 sig figs in that number. Zeros in front never count. Last rule, number 4, the zeros at the end. The zeros at the end of a number only count if they're also after a decimal point. So zeros at the end only count if they're after a decimal point. 0.0880. Okay, the zeros in front never count, so they don't count. The 8 and the 8 count. The 0 at the end is after the decimal point, and it's after the 8, so it counts. So zeros at the end count if they're also after a decimal point. So the 8, 8 and last zero count, 3 sig figs. And now the next last example, 28,500. 28,500. Okay, those zeros are at the end, but is there a decimal point? No, so they are placeholders. So only the 2, 8 and the 5 count, 3 sig figs. Now, can we get rid of those zeros and make it 285? No. If a car costs $28,500, you can't say, I'll give you $285 for it. That's not the same thing. Those zeros are important. They're placeholders. They're just not significant. So $28,500 has two placeholder zeros. Only the 2, 8, and 5 are significant. All right, those are our four rules on sig figs. Now, before we get to an example, I want to tell you about exact numbers. This is something that's counted, or it's a definition. It's not something that's measured. So like maybe there are 14 people in your lab. A definition would be 3 feet per yard. There's exactly 3 feet in a yard. 100 cents per dollar is also a definition. There's exactly 100 cents per dollar. So if you can use the word exactly, it's exact. In a ruler, there are 12 inches in a foot. That's exact. 12 inches in a foot. 5 iPods. Maybe there's 5 iPods in your city. Those are old things. People don't buy iPods anymore. 12 cans of beer. 12. That's an exact number. Not 11 and a half. You don't buy 11 and a half cans of beer. It's 12. 12 cans of beer. That's an exact number. What's not exact are measurements. 7 inches. Could have been 6.9 and they rounded up. 200 pounds. Could have been 199 pounds and they rounded it. 10 ounces. Could have been 10.2 ounces and they just rounded it. Those are measurements. They can be rounded. They're not exact. As we'll see later, significant figure rules don't apply to exact numbers like 100 cents per dollar or 3 feet per yard or 12 inches per foot. All right, this will be our last slide. I want you to tell me how many sig figs are in these measurements. I want you to pause here and look at them and answer in your head or write it down how many sig figs there are. So hit pause. Okay, I hope you hit pause and gave this a chance. This is what you're gonna need to do, especially if this is an online class, because this is your lecture. You do need to hit pause and give these examples a try in order to learn. You need to do things to learn, not just listen to me. So if you didn't, hit pause real quick and give these a real try. All right, first one, 5.05 centimeters has 3 sig figs. The 5 and the 5 count the zeros in between, so it counts. 3 sig figs. 1,200 milliliters. Those zeros are at the end, and there's no decimal point, so they're placeholders. So only the 1 and the 2 count, 2 sig figs. 0.02020. The 0.0 is in front. Zeros in front never count. But the 2020 do count, so 4. 4 sig figs. 2020. The first zero is in between the two, so it's in between, it counts. The last zero is at the end, and it's after a decimal point, so it counts. So the 2020 counts 4 sig figs. 0.0005 gallons. Zeros in front never count, so only the 5, 1 sig fig. 50 feet. Zero at the end doesn't have a decimal place, so it's a placeholder, so only the 5, 1 sig fig. Compare that to 50.00 feet. Yeah, those zeros at the end are after a decimal, so they count. And then that makes the zero in between them and the 5 count as well, because it's in between. So it's 4 sig figs, 50.00 feet. The first zero counts because it's in between sig figs. The zeros at the end are sig figs because they're after a decimal. 4 sig figs. All right, here's an easy one. 123.45. Yeah, all five. All five count. Five sig figs. Last one, 8,090 grams. Three sig figs, I hope you said. The 8 and the 9 count. The 0 in between them is in between, so it counts. 0 at the end doesn't have a decimal, so it doesn't count. It's a placeholder. Here's your answers. Good job, JCC. We're going to come back and do some more problems in the next video. Hope you're having a good time. Thank you.